Dear students, in this illustration, we'll discuss about the contact force between sliding blocks. Here you can see, we are given with two blocks A and B of masses M1 and M2, which are placed on an inclined plane, as shown, which has coefficient of friction mu1 and mu2 with the blocks A and B. It is given if mu1 is greater than mu2, we are required to find the contact force between the blocks while sliding. Now, in this situation here, if we draw the free body diagram of the two blocks, here we can see for block A, it is experiencing its weight mg in downward direction, and along the incline and normal to incline, if we draw the reference lines, here you can see one normal reaction N1 will act onto the block A in this direction. And one normal reaction is due to the block B, it is experiencing N2 in this direction. In this situation, this angle would be alpha, and here the force component of weight is mg cos alpha, and here it is mg sin alpha. And during its sliding, it will experience the friction in opposite direction, which is mu1 N1. And the value of N1 here we can use as mg cos alpha. Similarly, if we draw the free body diagram of block B, it is experiencing its weight m2g in downward direction. And these are the reference lines. Here, if this angle is alpha, the component of weights are m2g cos alpha. A normal reaction would be acting in this direction, say this N3. And N2 is acting, which is due to the block A, would be in opposite direction. And it will also slide due to M2G sin alpha. And it will experience a friction that is mu2 N3. So, in this situation, the value of N3 can be taken as M2G cos alpha. And if we write the sliding equation of motion for the two blocks, we can write the blocks slide together, we use if A is the acceleration with which both of these blocks are sliding, common equation of motion we can write m1 plus m2g sin alpha minus the friction acting on it is mu1 n1, this is mu1 m1g sin cos alpha plus mu2 m2g cos alpha. So we can write it as mu1 m1 plus mu2 m2 multiplied by g cos alpha. This is the total friction acting on the blocks is equals to m1 plus m2 multiplied by the acceleration. On solving, we are getting the acceleration of blocks as g sin alpha minus mu1 m1 plus mu2 m2 divided by m1 plus m2 g cos alpha. As we have got the acceleration, we can write the equation of motion for either block to get the value of n2, as we are required to find the contact force between the blocks, that is n2. So here we can write for block A. Only for block A we can see it is sliding due to the forces m1g sin alpha plus n2 minus the friction on it is mu1 m1g cos alpha is equals to m1a. If we substitute the value of A over here and analyze the whole thing after analysis, we get the value of n2 here. You can substitute the value of A over here. So, see what we are getting. It is m1g sin alpha plus n2 minus mu1 m1g cos alpha is equals to m1a. So, this m1g sin alpha and this will be minus m1g cos alpha multiplied by mu1 m1 plus mu2 m2. Divided by m1 plus m2. Here m1g sin alpha gets cancelled out, and on simplifying we are getting the value of n2. I'm leaving the simplification to you. You just simplify and verify the result of the contact force between the blocks, which we'll get is M1 M2 G cos alpha divided by M1 plus M2 multiplied by mu1 minus mu2. This is the final result of the problem we'll get.